Mike Bloomberg has just said that Occupy Wall Street's going to need permits to march. I want to hear what Norman Siegel, famed civil rights lawyer, has to say about this, because it sounds to me like Mike Bloomberg, who was like Mr. Musk, is violating their constitutional rights. And he said that Occupy Wall Street has been mostly peaceful. If that's the case, why have they been beaten? Why have they been pepper sprayed? And why so many arrests, especially the Brooklyn Bridge, because it looked like they were lured onto the bridge to do mass arrests of over 700 people. In the meantime, Mike broke campaign laws. He funneled money to Haggerty and to many different people using charity, using slush fund money, which is taxpayer money. Bloomberg News, he has the money managing. It was Quadrangle that became Willett's advisory. Then there's, what else? There's, oh God, there's so many ways that he did this. And Haggerty's going to jail. Why did the DA give Mike Bloomberg and a very long list of his people that work for him immunity, and Haggerty's the only one that doesn't get immunity? Something stinks here, especially because Mike should be in jail. He broke campaign laws that carries up to a year, and perjury carries even more time. So this is a nightmare. It's the biggest white-collar crimes we've ever had in New York City government under Mike Bloomberg, City Time, ECTP, NICAPs, Board of Ed Tech deals. And Mike's talking about permits and finding more ways to arrest Occupy Wall Street. I'll see you at City Hall Sunday, 2 o'clock. If there's more than 20 people, be on the east side by the subway entrances, the protest term limits. It's the third year anniversary of Christine Quinn selling the lie. We needed Mike to help us with the economy when more people fell into poverty. She is as corrupt as him. She is as mini-me.